everyone. So it's been a few months, hasn't it? So I wanted to give you updates as to what has happened and a summary of the videos I'll be posting along with this one. So you can check them out now or after this video if you'd like. You know, I just want to give you a summary so you know what you might want to watch. So yeah, I'll just get right into it. Back in February 14th, the day after my birthday, I woke up channeling and still have that ability. I could do it any day at any time. And at first it was light language and symbols and hand symbols and stuff and different voice and accent. It feels great. I feel it in my heart. It's really strong in my heart. And I have all these physiological effects while it's happening. Yeah, it feels incredible and I want to share that with you and the experience and tell you the process of it and everything. Another thing is I have proof now of the heart energy, because I kept asking universe, how can I prove this? Because I'm just talking and talking about it, right? My videos, how I can communicate and feel people remotely when they are thinking about me or writing to me, and I write to them, hey, you're thinking too much, it's like burning my heart, it's so strong. And it's like, how'd you know? You know, but I could prove to people one-on-one, but how can I prove to on camera? So I was sent a little butterfly, it was freezing, and I brought it in and warmed it up, and after it got warm, it was all happy and crawling on me, and at one point it flew to me, to my heart, and just got like fluttering for about 5 minutes right here. And I was like, what is going on? And I sent that video to someone. I was like, why is this butterfly molesting me? And they said, it's your heart energy. It's feeling your heart. And I was like, duh. Like, why didn't I think about that? It's not 5 minutes ago goes by. I can't not think about my heart because it's so strong, the energy I feel it. So, it's so great. And I taste the energy. It tastes good. Feeds me. Anyway, so I have that, and I had an encounter with a deer, which I didn't have my phone, but I'll talk about that in that video. I did a 6-day dry fast last month, no food or water for 6 days. It was great. I was camping and hiking. I had so much energy, so much joy and happiness, and it was just incredible. So I record myself on the 6th day talking about that. Another one with insights. And yeah, watch that. It's just because when I watched other people, they felt weak, and I haven't had any negative effects. And I definitely would never fast if I was feeling bad. You know, I want to make sure it's based on prana and spiritual energy, streaming that in. Another experience I had, which was more difficult to talk about, which is another reason why I was hesitant to post, because it's like, do you talk about these things, you know? And I want to write everything in detail in my book. I have so much to say. Just saying it on video, I want to explain everything in great detail and how I came to these understandings. You know, a lot of it's from birth. I just knew things at birth and from a young child, just born with this knowledge and this energy. But, you know, I want to explain it all in more detail there before I do too many videos about it. You know, I just want people to fully understand. But this could change relationships, which is what I've experienced. When you experience things, the physical process, 100 times stronger than you would if someone was there. I mean, I'm not even joking. It blows your mind, and you research, you can't find anything like that. I found one lady who had an experience like that. One. So we need to have a soulmate connection. And just trying to tell someone you had that, and they're just, you know, it's obviously very difficult, because you want to get down to the bottom of how it happened and why, and it's not what people would think. You know, they would think, oh, you know, it's some energy thing. I mean, it's an energy connection, but it's not what one would think, because I interrogated the person for like for months, and they told me over and over, and I even asked psychics, and they said no, they didn't do anything on purpose. I mean, I was just freaking out because of how strong it was. I go into all the details in the video, so yeah, if you want to watch that and more in the book, as I say, so another thing is, you may have seen me not put comments or judgment, or what's it like, think, you know, up or down, like, yeah, whatever, you know, because we're only encouraging, even though I get lots of likes and positive comments, but I'm only encouraging others to judge and to be based on the ego, and when we all have our own experiences and perspectives, and it only seems to keep the consciousness of the planet in a judgmental manner. And growing up, I always wondered, like, why are people so judgmental? And, you know, if I ask others to judge me, even if it's positively, it's just, like, what's even the point? That's not fifth dimensional thinking. It's third dimensional or lower, you know? It's so sad that we're actually encouraging that, because, you know, growing up, I was really open-minded. I was always friends with those that were judged the harshest, because I found them really interesting and fun, and I wanted to learn from them what nobody else knew. And I just think the judgment thing is the same thing. When we're all different and unique, you know, and one day you might agree with someone, the next day, because you're having a different kind of day, you might disagree. Or based on your knowledge or understanding, so it never has made sense to me, but maybe sometimes I'll keep it on there, sometimes I won't. And another thing I want to talk about is consumerism, because if I can go a long time without eating, and I honestly can live off of very little money, and I'm happy, and I create out of nothing, and I manifest when I need something, and I just think people are so spoiled and lazy. When are we going to snap out of that? Like, man up, woman up. Like, realize the potential here. Realize the creation energy. You know, you don't need to be so dependent. And I definitely want to talk about that. So I have a video, should have a video about that. Because, you know, I tell people I did the fast. I get, oh, you're brave, or oh, you're strong. Maybe compared to Earth standards. I mean, this place, people are just so dense, stuck, and like, it's not that hard. And just to use your flippant perspective, that's really all it has to do with. People think it's stuff's hard, and it's not. It's so easy. You're just stuck in a rut of thinking because you've been brainwashed to think that way. Okay? So I'll talk about that. Y'all hear me all. people are so lazy, especially as Americans. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I hope you watch the videos. I'm so glad to be back. And I'll post next, should be posting a video about this month's fast, however long that will be. Because it's just a test to see how long I feel good, you know? If I had any negative symptom, I probably would quit, you know? Like, if I felt weak or felt craving or something. Alright, that's all I have to say for now, so, bye guys.